The first rule of beekeeping, don't get emotionally attached. Okay, so maybe I've never actually heard a beekeeper tell somebody, don't get emotionally attached. It's kind of weird advice, because we're dealing with bugs, okay? And they have no emotional connection to us. They never say thanks. They just do their thing, and we provide a place for them to do it. But when you put a lot of time and energy into something like beekeeping, it's hard not to feel a connection. For example, the colony that we're going to be inspecting today is my first colony that was put into the apiary. I call this my mother colony. It was the original colony that I got through a trap out of a tree not far from our house. And it was a very successful trap out, got the bees and the queen out within about a week, and brought them home, put them into the hive. And from there, in order to improve the chances of having at least one colony that would get through winter, I split that colony into three more. So now I have four colonies from that one original. So emotional attachment, well, I feel like I owe a lot to that colony. I've put a lot into it and have gotten a lot from it in terms of populating other hives in our apiary. But when it comes down to it, they're bugs. And there's a strong chance that some of these bugs, some of these colonies are not going to survive through winter. So try not to get too attached, but I've invested a lot. And now we're going to go in. We haven't yet inspected this colony on video, so we're going to check them out today, see how they're doing. To be honest, I'm not even sure what we're going to find. They've always seemed pretty strong, but as I split them, I was taking the choice frames of brood from that colony to start new ones. And so for a long time, I've just kind of let them alone now, let them build back up after I took out good brood frames. And recently, they haven't shown a lot of healthy traffic at the entrance. So, not sure what we're going to find, but we'll find out together. Let's get into it. So, before I open up this colony, I want to tell you a little bit about this hive. As you know if you've watched my other videos, I keep bees in Layens hives, as opposed to Langstroth, which is pretty much the standard for most beekeepers in the U.S. And for those who are interested in converting from Langstroth to Layens, you might be interested to know that this hive that I'm going to be getting into was built from Langstroth boxes. I found out that if you take the Langstroth boxes, stack them up to give yourself enough height for the Layens frames, and turn it 90 degrees, put a half inch plywood on each side, that gives you the right amount of space for 12 Layens frames at a 90 degree orientation to the way the Langstroth frames were. It's about a perfect fit. So worked out pretty well. And then once I got it built, I started trimming it out with cedar, and sometimes I don't know when to stop, put on a hinged lid. And the only thing I would do different is to give more of a gap at the top of it. I reused the telescoping cover with an inner cover inside. Do I need the inner cover with the Layens frames? Probably not. I'm not sure it really serves a purpose, but it's still there. And that's all the more gap that I have on above those Layens frames to the lid. If I were building this again, I would make the lid a little higher, leave a little more gap there, allow me to put a little more insulation on top for winterizing. But that's a different story. I just wanted to mention that since I was talking about how the hive was built. So let's open it up and we'll see how the bees are doing. Here, got some bees down in here, so we're not beeless. As I opened this up, I saw, you know, look like a roach, look like a moth, all sorts of stuff up here on top of the inner cover, but it does look like we still have bees in here. We'll see how they're doing. Now in this hive, the entrance is right towards the middle of the hive. If I built it again, I might do that a little differently, but that's the way it is. So I'm going to start from close to the entrance and work my way to the end. So we we can see we have 7 frames in here total. And this last frame, they have hardly anything on. It's a wax foundation, little tiny bit of wax built out. More, they've chewed holes in the sides to get through to the other side. It's made passageways, so not much there. This next frame has more built out. There's not a whole lot stored in here. You can tell there was brood on here by the dark comb, but there's no brood now. It does look like they might have a little bit. They got some nectar stored up in there. They're kind of storing nectar back into the brood area, which tells me they may be kind of starting to get ready for winter, which is not a bad thing. It'd just be nice to see more resources in there. Second frame, kind of the same story. An older brood frame, the comb is dark. Besides seeing a little bit of nectar glistening in there, there's really not much stored up in here. For those who watched my previous video about inspecting the cemetery swarm, it was a 2-part video. This is kind of the same story we saw there, except these bees do have some nectar in here, but otherwise, that's it. Third frame, we're kind of seeing a repeat of the story here. Again, this is a brood frame. We've got some drone cells on here, nothing in there. Got some old brood cells. Got some nectar stored in there. But nothing else. Yeah, this is like a record on repeat. We've got a little more nectar in here. There's no capped honey. I'm not seeing any pollen. And again, this is my first year keeping bees, but I would be very surprised if the bees would completely shut down laying this early. I could be wrong, but I'm kind of surprised that there's no brood at all in here. And this could be a queenless issue potentially, but these bees don't act queenless. They are very calm, they're quiet. A queenless hive will generally be louder, a little more agitated, a little more temperamental. These bees are very calm and very docile right now. Now you can see this is quite a bit more comb on here. But again, it's darker brood comb. A lot of drone cells at the top. Old drone cells, nothing new there. But I'm just not really much at all stored up in this one. There's no brood at all. So this is a little disconcerting. Last frame, I'm not even going to pull out. It's just a frame of foundation, so nothing really built on there. So this is a little concerning to me. This is kind of like previous inspections that I did recently, where the bees had, in that case, they still had some cap brood. These have no cap brood. They have no brood at all. I saw no larvae in there, no eggs, you know, nothing of that sort. All I saw was a little bit of nectar stored in there, but no capped honey. So, these bees have gone through whatever resources they had. They have no additional brood right now to develop new bees, to get through winter. I'm kind of concerned about the future of this colony. So this is where not getting emotionally attached comes in, because I'm going to have to make some hard decisions here. At this state, I'll be coming back and inspecting these bees in a couple weeks. I don't expect I'm going to see a whole lot of difference. I can feed aggressively to try to build them up some resources, but I just don't know that they're going to be equipped to get through winter. So we may end up combining this colony with other colonies. So some tough decisions coming up. Going to have to think about that, look at the other hives, see the state of them. I was really hoping this hive would be in better shape than what I'm seeing right now. But that's the way it goes sometimes. A little bit disappointing. Well, no, a lot disappointing. But we'll have to decide in a couple weeks what we're going to do. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.